subconscious mind. Another is unconscious mind. Human brain sleeps or take rest only for 2 to 3 hours. Say you get up at 5 o'clock, just giving an example. Your mind will get up at 3:30 or 4 o'clock, an hour before. You will also be surprised that a human brain gets 50 to 70,000 bubble thought in 24 hours. You know bubble? Pani ka bulbula, doodh ka bulbula. So that tinkle means 1/10 of second. That kind of thoughts, 50 to 70,000 bubble thoughts, a human brain gets in 24 hours. Now connect to it. I will tell you how we can make the destiny of a human. Now as I said, 50 to 70,000 bubble thoughts, many of them are good, few of them are negative also. And every human in the globe gets positive and negative thoughts. Now selection of those thoughts, those bubble thoughts, and again rethought on it is very important. Once we have given rethought, then we start working on it. It could be negative, it could be positive. Now couple of months and you are trying to go in deep sleep. This is subconscious mind. Another is unconscious mind. Human brain sleeps or take rest only for 2 to 3 hours. Say you get up at 5 o'clock, just giving an example. Your mind will get up at 3:30 or 4 o'clock. An hour before. You will also be surprised that a human brain gets 50 to 70,000 bubble thought in 24 hours. You know bubble? Pani ka bulbula, doodh ka bulbula. So that tinkle means 1/10 of second. That kind of thoughts, 50 to 70,000 bubble thoughts, a human brain gets in 24 hours. Now connect to it. I will tell you how we can make the destiny of a human. Now as I said, 50 to 70,000 bubble thought, many of them are good, few of them are negative also. And every human in the globe gets positive and negative thoughts. Now selection of those thoughts, those bubble thoughts, and again rethought on it is very important. Once we have given rethought, then we start working on it. It could be negative, writing is for 3 days and writing is for decades. So that you have to teach. So interactive session, that is the reason. When you will be knowing his thought or her thought, then only you can do the correction, isn't it? So speak to her, speak to him, and find out what by his words, by his body language, you will come to know what kind of person he is or she is. So verbal communication is very important. Second is non-verbal communication. Non-verbal communication. Now there are 1,000 body languages. I will give you a few examples. I am sitting like this. This is the thinking mode. I am like this. I am full of sadness. Similarly, when you are sitting in a chair, it also speaks the body language without